So Google ranking factors like the secure browsing HTTPS and avoiding keyword stuffing are a norm, so we will not discuss about them. But what are the other important ranking factors we should consider to rank highly on the search results? Let's find out in this video. Let's go. Hey, it's Jack from RankMath, the one SEO plugin that empowers millions of WordPress sites, and this channel is all about helping you grow your search traffic. So if you're new to us, subscribe. So what we are going to talk about is by no means in order of importance because they are all important. So we will start with this. Quality content is a huge blanket that covers many aspects of SEO, but what Google is really looking for is content that helps users find what they are looking for in the quickest way possible. For example, the keyword, how to tie a tie. If you have article A that goes straight into the step-by-step tutorial that has only 600 words, and you have article B that has 2,500 words that goes into the history of a tie, the theory of a tie, when the culture started, and then they go into the tutorial, most of the time you'll see that article A is doing much better than article B on the search results. Quality content is all about how well the users perceive your content. It is not about the search engines. And in situations where the top 10 search results are fulfilling the search intent in the quickest way possible, all of them are quality content, how can you compete with them? The key lies in the insights you can provide. For example, the keyword best budget laptop for students. All the sites that are currently ranking in the top 10 have provided a list of budget laptops, sharing the specs, pros and cons, and everything. So what more can you add to outrank these sites? I can think of interviewing real students and putting them into a case study. And when everyone else is focused on the specs and price, you can discuss the long-term durability and the ease of upgrades for the laptop. There are many ways to create original high-quality content. You just have to figure out an angle that all the currently ranked pages are missing. I know this is easier said than done. So maybe this list of page elements can help you make the content more insightful to outrank your competitors. Feel free to pause this and jot them down. And if you need help writing the first draft of your content, we have an AI tool that can write long-form content for you. The tool is called Blog Post Wizard in the Content AI module. Let's open this up. Now, if you know what keyword to target for your blog post, you can skip this step because the first step is to generate a blog post idea. So let's skip this. The next step will be to generate a blog post outline. And since we know what topic we are targeting, let's add it here. Say best wood for smoking vegetables. And then for the main points and ideas, I will leave this empty for the AI to generate the ideas. Or you can click this for the AI to generate the ideas for you. But personally, I like to leave this empty. And then select an audience, say foodies. And then add a focus keyword, which most of the time will be the same as the topic. And then for the blog post outline, I prefer to have the tone as formal. I will change it later for the content. And then for the style, there are many options to choose from, but I would say it's going to be a listicle. Since I'm expecting a list of wood, this is at your discretion. Choose a language. There are over 28 languages to choose from, but let's keep it as English and let's hit generate. In a while, you will have a blog post outline for the topic. If you don't think this is good enough, you can always hit regenerate. But if you're happy with it, let's change the tone to informal and maybe conversational and click write post. Just give it a couple of seconds, up to maybe a minute. A complete piece of comprehensive content will be generated. As you can see, we have a FAQ section, and then a conclusion, some advice about combining woods for unique flavors, and then the list of different woods for smoking vegetables, coupled with the introduction. And as you can see, it has generated more than 1800 words. Now to make this generated content into a blog post, you can simply click on create new post, and a new blog post that is well formatted will be created. From here, you can add your knowledge, experience, and expertise to the content. Do not take this content as it is. This tool is meant to create the first draft and not the final. So you definitely have to fact check and add your inputs. But I would say this is around 80% complete. So writing high quality content is as easy as ever. All you need to do is to add elements that will make your content more insightful. Having keywords in strategic locations increases the chance of getting search engines to take notice of your content. This is a page from Google that tells us how contents are ranked on the search results. First, they assess the search query to understand its meaning, so that they know what you're looking for as a user. And then they analyze the content to assess if it contains the same keyword as the search query. Which means if the content you are writing contains the same keyword other people are searching for, your content will be considered in the search results. However, we are not going back to the days where you stuff the page with the same keywords and you will rank. Those are spammy ads. Nowadays, we need to place keywords in strategic areas on the page, such as having the main focus keyword in the SEO title and description, in the URL, at the beginning of the content, in one of the image alt tags, and at the start of the SEO title. And if you're having troubles fixing these SEO issues, simply click on the Fix with AI button and they will fix the issue for you. And all you have to do is to click Approve and this issue will be fixed. So all these are part of RankMap SEO tests to make sure that your content is optimized for the search engines. So as long as your page has keywords in those strategic places, they will be considered in the search results. But that's not all. They say the more the merrier, but in terms of SEO, the quality of backlinks comes first. Right after sorting the content with high relevance, Google will assess the content quality through signals such as expertise, authoritativeness, and trustworthiness. Google relies on signals to know if a content is trustworthy, such as if other prominent websites link or refer to the content. It is generally a good sign that the information is trustworthy. Never try to acquire backlinks through spammy ads, like buying and selling links for ranking purposes, excessive link exchanges, using automated programs or services to create links to your site, and all these are considered link spams. We have left a link to this page in the description if you are interested to learn more about different spammy ads. So the question is, how do you attract other prominent sites to link to yours? We have actually covered this topic on this video that talks about the different phases of link building and what you should do to acquire high quality backlinks. Go check it out. But one tip you can take away is that do not create content that competes with prominent sites, but instead create content that supports them. Earlier, we talked about how Google determines the trustworthiness of the content and it all ties into the EAT framework. But there is another element to it, which is experience. This is a ranking factor for keywords that requires practical experience or first-hand knowledge. For example, when we search for the keyword backpacking in Krabi and we check out, for example, this page, and then we compare it to a content on page 2, such as this, and we can see that the page that is ranking at the top displayed authentic images showing true experience. This lady was in fact on a backpacking trip in Krabi. While this other page that is ranking on page 2 consists of words with no evidence of first-hand experience. If images cannot prove experience, such as for a technical review on a digital product, then use research data you have personally conducted as proof of experience. And on top of proving experience, you should also consider showcasing your expertise by adding, for example, your professional certificates if it makes sense. If you are ranking for keywords like how to run Google Ads, it will be helpful if you have certifications on your page such as Google Certified Partner. So pages that demonstrate first-hand experience and expertise often outranks generic pages with basic information. Google is looking for additional value on top of the basic content. If you want to dig deeper into optimizing your content for EEAT, you can check out this video right here. It used to be all about the number of new posts you publish, but not anymore. Now it is about the frequency of your updates, making sure that your content stays relevant and fresh. Regularly updating your content signals to the search engines that your website is active and provides current and relevant information, which can lead to higher crawl rates and better search rankings. If you do a simple search on a keywords that have high search volume, such as RankMath review, let's check out this page. This was updated a couple months back. And then let's scroll down. These are all community pages, so we will not talk about them. Let's check this out. This was updated a month back. And then how about this? This was updated close to 2 months ago. So you will realize that Google favors recently updated content, especially on keywords that have high search volume. So if you want to have a leg up on your competitors, update your content at least once every 12 months. Technical SEO is a crucial ranking factor because it ensures that your website is optimized for both search engines and users in terms of performance, structure, and accessibility. First to talk about in technical SEO is mobile friendliness. Everyone is searching for something using their mobile devices, so if your site is not optimized for mobile, your page will not rank. Use a tool like the mobile friendliness test tool by Bing to test your pages. Add your page URL here and hit analyze. And it will tell if your page is mobile friendly and if there are anything else that can be optimized. The next item in technical SEO is website speed. The faster your page loads, the better the user experience. However, if your page takes 5 to 10 seconds to load, your site may be perceived as spammy and people will leave immediately. So the best way to know if your site is optimized for speed is to check it with Google's PageSpeed Insights. This is the tool and this is the URL. Simply paste your page URL here and run the test. Give it a while and you will see the results. What we are focusing on is the mobile performance. If your site is well established, you will see data from real user experience. These data are taken from Chrome users who have visited your site or page. The top three metrics are the most significant, and they are part of the Core Web Vitals assessment. You can toggle the results for this URL and for your entire site. And to optimize your page for speed, you have to check out the performance test, and your page will be tested with these metrics. You should aim for a score of 90 and above. Scrolling down and you will see a list of items to optimize for speed. Now, optimizing for page speed is a huge topic and we cannot cover everything in this video. So we have created this video that will break down everything you need to do to make your page load fast. And if you want to understand every metric and test from the Google PageSpeed Insights, you can check out this video. The links to these videos are in the description. Do not view SEO as just written content. Even if you are an individual, you should create content with the mindset of starting a brand. Google increasingly values brand authority and consistency. For example, if you are a brand that sells BBQ tools, having a strong presence on Instagram where you share tips, YouTube where you upload tutorial videos, and being mentioned in reputable BBQ blogs will help reinforce your brand's credibility in Google's eyes. This kind of exposure enhances your experience, expertise, authoritativeness, and trustworthiness, which are important ranking signals we have discussed. So do not just have a blog, have a YouTube channel, an Instagram account, a Facebook account, an X account, and appear everywhere. Don't worry about time constraints and budget because we have many AI tools that will help you out. Like the Facebook Post AI tool that will help write your post in no time, write an Instagram caption in seconds, write your YouTube script and description, and many more. We have you covered, so you don't have to worry about not having the time to manage different social accounts. With all that is being said, you've got to track the behavioral factors of your pages because they are ranking factors, such as the click-through rate. If your page appears on a search but is hardly being clicked, it tells Google that your SEO title and possibly your content may not be aligned with the search's intent. When you go to your search console and click on the performance tab, then visit the pages tab, you want to take notice of pages that are ranking on the top 10 results, yet the click-through rate is below 3%. Some are category pages, so it doesn't really matter. But for content-heavy pages, if the position is high and there are high impressions, but the click-through rate is below 3%, then it is an indicator to optimize your SEO title to make it more attractive to click. Maybe having a special character or emoji can help. For example, when we search for emoji and SEO, we can see the SEO title of this page has a rocket emoji. Maybe this can help boost the click-through rate. On top of the click-through rate, you should also track the average session duration of each page. It is the duration a user spends on a page before returning to the search results, and it is often used as a signal for content quality and relevance. Allow me to show you a real example. On Google Analytics, go to your reports, and under View User Engagement and Retention, you want to click on Pages and Screens. Here, you will see all the pages of your site together with the relevant data. Let me expand the number of rows per page. And what we are looking out for is the average engagement time per active user. As you can see, most of the pages have an average engagement time of around a minute, and that is the norm for the site. And when there is an anomaly, such as this, This is supposed to be a content-heavy page. It is getting an average engagement of 11 seconds out of the 17 people who have visited the page. So if we visit the page, we can see that the quality of the content is really not up to par. So we have to do something about it, otherwise the performance of this page will never improve. So keep track of the user engagement time and the click-through rate. If you see that a page is suffering from these metrics, you really have to take a look at them and make sure to improve them. Let me share an engagement hack with you. Make sure that the content answers the search query or the main focus keyword in the first 100 words of your content to captivate your audience immediately. Once they see value in your content, they will naturally stay longer. So these are the important Google ranking factors we have discussed. And of course, there are many more. We have left a link to our written content in the description. Are you getting value from this video? If yes, can you do us a favor and smash that thumbs up? And if you have any questions or suggestions, feel free to let us know in the comments down below. Our channel is all about helping you grow your search traffic. And if you haven't subscribed to us, consider doing so. This is Jack from RankMath. I'll see you in the next video.